Welcome to TCube Gate Classing. Myself Dr. Rajiv Malik. I have done my PhD from NIT Kurukshetra and I have done my M.Tech from NIT Jalandhar. Currently, I am working as an assistant professor in College of Technology, Pantnagar. I have teaching experience of 3.5 years. I will teach you some topics of digital communication. Now, let's start the digital communication, basic concept of digital communication. For the digital communication, we have to know the concept of signal system and analog communication. So, let's start from basic concept of digital communication. First, we studied the pulse modulation. Pulse modulation is used in digital communication. As all of you studied the continuous wave modulation in analog communication. Continuous wave modulation. In continuous wave modulation, sinusoidal carrier signal is used. Sinusoidal carrier signal is used for the transmission purpose, and we know that some parameter of the carrier signal is continuously varied with the message signal. Some parameter or the characteristics of the carrier signal is continuously varied in accordance with the message signal. In same way, we study the pulse modulation. In pulse modulation, pulse train is used as a carrier signal. Pulse train is used as a carrier signal. And the some parameter or the characteristics of pulse train is varied in accordance with the message signal. Some parameter of pulse train is varied in accordance with the message signal. Message signal is also known as information signal. Pulse modulation is of two type. It is of two type. One is analog pulse modulation. Another is digital pulse modulation. Now we define the analog pulse modulation. In analog pulse modulation, periodic pulse train is used as a carrier signal. Periodic pulse train is used as a carrier signal. And some characteristics some characteristics of each pulse characteristics may be position width or amplitude is varied in accordance with the sample value of the message signal In analog pulse modulation, information is transmitted in analog form. But at discrete instant of time. Next, we studied the digital pulse modulation. In digital pulse modulation, information is represented in a form that is discrete in time and discrete in amplitude. Information is represented in a form that is discrete in time and discrete in amplitude. So this condition permits. This condition permits its transmission in sequence coded form. So in digital pulse modulation, information is transmitted in sequence coded form. There is no continuous waveform in digital pulse modulation, and coded pulses is basic for the digital coded. Pulses is basic for digital communication. And for the pulse modulation, sampling process is required. Sampling process is basic for both type of pulse modulation. Either it is analog pulse modulation or digital pulse modulation. and sampling process is basic for digital communication. Now we discuss sampling process. Sampling process is usually described in time domain. It is the operation which is performed in time domain. And it is basic for digital communication. It is basic for digital signal processing and digital communication. By the use of sampling process, analog information is converted into a sequence of sample by the use of sampling process analog information is converted into corresponding sequence of samples. That is uniformly spaced in time. This is the sampling process. Once again, we define the sampling process. By the use of sampling process, analog information is converted into corresponding sequence of sample that is uniformly spaced in time. And for the sampling process, we have to choose the sampling rate properly. For the practical utility of the sampling process, we have to choose the sampling rate properly. We have to choose the sampling rate properly. So that sequence of sample define the original signal. So that sequence of sample defines the original signal. This is the condition. We have to choose the sampling rate properly. So the sample defines the original signal. Next, we define the mathematics of sampling process. Consider a signal. For mathematics of the sampling process, consider a signal. GT having finite energy having finite energy and defined for all time t. As we know that some signal has energy, some signal has power. So here we consider a signal that is energy signal and having finite energy. Next we take the segment of signal GT. As shown in figure. We take a segment of this This is our original signal GT, which is defined for all time t. Now we apply sampling process on this signal. We instantaneously sample this signal. This is t is equal to 0. Now we apply instantaneous sampling. It means we sample the signal which are uniformly spaced in time. First we sample the signal at t is equal to 0. This is, if we plot at t is equal to 0, we sample. Next, we sample the signal at t is equal to ts. Second, next sample is at t is equal to ts. Next sample is at t is equal to 2ts. Next at t is equal to 3ts, 4ts, in same way we obtain negative side we sample the signal at t is equal to minus ts, minus 2ts, minus 3ts. So we obtain a infinite sequence of sample. We obtain infinite sequence of samples. Infinite sequence of samples that are uniformly spaced in time and samples are ts second apart. Ts is the sampling period. This is known as two samples are separated by a time, that is sampling period. And reciprocal of sampling period is sampling rate. This is the sampling rate. This is our sample signal. We obtain infinite sequence of signals and it is known as an ideal sampled signal. And it is denoted by G of del t. This is ideal sampled signal. After sampling, first we consider a segment of signal Gt having finite energy. After that we apply the instantaneous sampling, or we sample the signal at instant, at discrete instant of time. We sample the segment of signal Gt and we obtain the infinite sequence of sample, and the sample are ts second apart. Now we can denote this sample signal with the equation. We can denote the sample signal. We can denote the sample signal with the direct delta function. Sample signal with the direct delta function and we assign a mass to the direct delta function. G of del t can be represented with the help of this equation, n minus infinity to infinity g of nts del t minus nts. This is the representation of the sample signal. This is direct delta function or impulse function. Direct delta function or impulse function. Which is position at t is equal to nts. As you all know, you know the representation of impulse function. This impulse function is represented at t is equal to nts, and this is the mass assigned to the each sample value. This is the mass assigned to the samples at t is equal to nts. This is mass assigned to the sample at t is equal to nts. N can take all, n can take all integer value. N take the value from minus infinity to infinity. This is the ideal sample signal, and we can represent it to the with the help of direct delta function and the mass assigned to the each sample value. This is the mass assigned to the each sample value. When n changes, the sample value also changes. Now we have to find out the Fourier transform for the sampling process. Next, we have to find out the Fourier transform of this sample signal. This sample signal can also be obtained with the help of a infinite pulse train. G of del t is also obtained with the help of infinite pulse train. We multiply the Gt with the infinite pulse train Pt. Pt is the infinite pulse train that is represented in a figure. It is the periodic pulse train. This is periodic infinite pulse train. This is 0 TS, 2 TS, 3 TS up to infinite. In same way, minus TS, this is my periodic infinite periodic pulse train and represented with the help of T is equal to minus infinity, n is equal to minus infinity to infinity, del T minus NTS. This is the representation of infinite periodic pulse train. Now we have to find out the Fourier transform of this sampled signal. So Fourier, we have to find out the Fourier transform of two multiplied signal. As all of you know that multiplication in time domain is equivalent to the convolution in frequency domain. This is the Fourier transform. So we all of know that the multiplication of the signal in time domain is equivalent to the convolution of the signal in frequency domain. So it is equivalent to 1 by 2 pi g of omega into convolution with e of omega. So to find out the Fourier transform of sample signal, we have to calculate the Fourier transform of pulse train. Now we calculate the pulse train, Fourier transform of pulse train. This is Fourier transform of the, we have to find out the Fourier transform of pulse train. Fourier signal can be represented periodic signal can be represented with the help of Fourier series, complex Fourier series representation. We can represent any periodic signal with the help of exponential complex Fourier series representation. So we can represent this periodic signal with the help of complex exponentially Fourier series representation. This is CK e to the power JK omega TS. This is the representation of periodic signal in Fourier series. This is complex Fourier series representation of periodic signal. First of all, we have to calculate the CK. This is the Fourier series coefficient. CK is the Fourier series coefficient. Now we have to calculate the CK. There is a formula in Fourier series to calculate the Fourier series coefficient. This is 1 by TS. TS is the time period. Minus TS by 2 to TS by 2. PT e to the power minus J A. Omega is T dt. This is the formula to calculate the Fourier series coefficient as from the figure. This is T is equal to 0. This is TS. This is minus TS, 2TS minus 2TS. This is periodic pulse train, infinite periodic. This is minus TS by 2, this is TS by 2. So from minus TS by 2, this is PT is equal to del T. It is from minus Ts by 2 say it is del T. Now put from minus Ts by 2 to Ts by 2 Pt is del T. Put the value of in the formula, we calculate 1 by Ts minus Ts by 2 Ts by 2 del T e to the power minus j k omega s t dt. Del T is only defined at t is equal to 0. So this integration come out to be 1. When we put t is equal to 0 here, del T is only defined at t is equal to 0. This integration come out to be 1. So we get Ck is equal to 1 by Ts. This is the value of Fourier series coefficient, 1 by Ts, Ck is 1 by Ts all time. Now we put it in the Fourier transform equation. K minus infinity to infinity, 1 by Ts, and Fourier transform of e to the power j k omega s t. This we have to find out the Fourier transform of this function. Now we use the duality property. As all of you know that duality property in Fourier transform. Now we find out the Fourier transform of this exponential function. Duality property. By the use of duality property, we have to find out the Fourier transform of exponential function. As we know that del T is Fourier transform is 1. And 1 by the duality property, 1 having Fourier transform 2 pi del omega. In same way, if 1 is multiplied with the exponential function jk omega st, and we have to calculate the Fourier transform. This is the shifting property. If we multiply any signal with the exponential function, there is a frequency shifting property. Then the 1 is having Fourier transform 2 pi omega. If you multiply with the exponential function, there is a shift in frequency with the frequency. This is the frequency of exponential function. So 2 pi del of omega minus k omega s. This is the shifting property. And we put in the Fourier transform of periodic pulse train. K minus infinity to infinity, 1 by Ts. And Fourier transform of exponential function is 2 pi del of omega minus k omega s. This is the Fourier transform of periodic pulse train. Now we can calculate the Fourier transform of sample signal g of del omega. As we mentioned in the previous equation, that is equivalent to the 1 by 2 pi convolution of the Fourier transform of original signal with the convolution with the Fourier transform of pulse train. This is the Fourier transform of sample signal. This come out to be 1 by 2 pi. Now we put the value of p omega. From here to here, this is equivalent to g of omega convolved with 2 pi by Ts k minus infinity to infinity del of omega minus k omega s. This come out to be after solving 1 by Ts g of omega कंबोल विद डेल के माइनस इंफिनिटी डेल ओ ओमेगा माइनस के ओमेगा एस. As we know the convolution property of the impulse function. Now, with the convolution property of the impulse function, we get the final result of 1 by Ts G of omega minus K omega S, and the here we put the summation K is minus infinity to infinity. This is the final Fourier transform of sampled signal. Fourier transform of sampled signal is find out to be 1 by Ts A minus infinity to infinity G of omega minus K omega S. This is in radian. Now we can find out 1 by Ts is 1 by Ts is the sampling rate. So it can be a in hertz, it is Fs is minus infinity to infinity G of F minus AFS. This is the spectrum of the sampled signal. This is the spectrum of the sampled signal. Now we can conclude that uniformly sampling of the continuous finite signal results in a spectrum that is periodic in a frequency having period fs. Now conclusion is sampling of a continuously sampling of a continuously signal having finite energy. Sampling of a continuous signal having finite energy. Having finite energy. Results in a spectrum that is periodic in frequency having period fs, your sampling rate. This is the conclusion for this equation, because fs is the period of this spectrum. In next lecture we plot its spectrum and we have to find out the discrete time Fourier transform of the sample signal, and after that we compare the both equation and find the Fourier transform of sample signal in term of sample values. So I stop here. Now in next lecture we have to find out the discrete time Fourier transform of the sample signal, and we compare with this equation and we plot the spectrum of the sample signal and define how the sample value contain all the information of the original signal.